right. And with that demo, that is basically the end of the lesson. So we're going to do a quick checkpoint here. We've got a couple of quiz questions, and then we're also going to do a brief summary, and then we're going to turn you loose on a lab so that you can try it out yourself. Our first quiz question is, which of the following are true about object storage? A, not all object storage is S3 compatible. B, object storage requires large objects. C, applications access object storage using the RESTful API. D, applications access object storage using a proprietary protocol. Or E, object storage requires specialty hardware. So the answers are A and C. A, not all object storage is S3 compatible. That's true. MinIO spends lots of time reverse engineering and testing to be S3 compatible. And C, applications access object storage using a RESTful API. Also true. Our command line client may seem like it's a proprietary protocol. It is not. It is really just using the RESTful API underneath. The console is accessing through the RESTful API. Our SDKs use the RESTful API. Everything that accesses our storage is using the RESTful API. Our second question is this. Which of the following are true about MinIO? A, MinIO implements a subset of S3 APIs. B, you can deploy MinIO to any cloud infrastructure or platform. C, MinIO requires specialty hardware through a vendor partner. D, MinIO extends certain S3 features while maintaining compatibility. Or E, MinIO deployments consist of separate data and router nodes. And the answers for this one are B and D. You can deploy MinIO to any cloud infrastructure or platform. You can deploy it to AWS. You can deploy it to Google Cloud. You can deploy it to Azure. You can deploy it to DataOcean, wherever you want to deploy it to. You are in good hands with MinIO. And D, MinIO extends certain S3 features while maintaining compatibility. We are fully S3 compatible, but there are certain parts of the S3 API that we have extended beyond just the basic S3 feature. And this brings us to our summary. So what did we learn here in this lesson? Just a brief summary on what we've covered. MinIO is high performance S3 compatible object storage. We spend a lot of time again doing reverse engineering testing to make sure that we are fully compatible, fully S3 compatible. You can run MinIO in a local Docker container all the way up to a full cloud deployment. MinIO is very flexible. You can run it on pretty much any hardware that's available, any modern hardware that's available today. And to set up a simple dev environment, you start your server, create a bucket, and add a client user. It's just that simple. And from there, you can start developing your proof of concept.